Hello there, everyone. AnthWolf here, playing even more Final Fantasy XIV. Playing as our level 80 Dark Knight, Yuri Yascaret, once again here in the Raktika Greatwood, where we finally were reunited with Yastola. Now, apparently there's some custom here in the Greatwood where one does not use one's own name, so she's going under the title Master Matoya right now. And the Crystal Exarch asked us to retrieve an ancient tablet, which she is not happy about, really, because, well, she sees through the Exarch's appeal to be friendly with her once again, and that it's come at a very serendipitous time. I can't even say the word. Where it might be useful to gain access and to defeat the third Light Warden, the Light Warden in this region. So, Fancred kind of went off a bit frustrated with Yastola when she confronted him about whether or not he could accept what happened to Minfilia, and obviously the younger Minfilia here. And between the previous stream and this one, or the last video, if you're watching this later on YouTube, I spent a little bit of time exploring the Aether Currents here in the Raktika Greatwood. If you have a quick look at the map, it seems that the Greatwood is actually split into two halves again. There's actually a barrier here preventing us from traveling further to the east. But we unlocked what Aether Currents we could in this region. And just before I started this stream, I actually ran my duty roulettes once again. And so I have 1200 tomestones of Gotia. But apart from that, Yastola has recommended we get to know the village and the blessed that are here while she and Yurion J are translating that tablet. So I expect a whole multitude of missions to become available for us. A day in the neighborhood. Yastola is staring off into the distance, lost in thought. Okay. So yeah, apparently there is a tribe to the east that are preventing Yastola and others from exploring this eastern region of the Greatwood. And that's a good possibility for where the Light Warden is hiding. Okay, so we're learning a bit more of the Knight's Blessed customs. Is there a vendor here? Maybe there is, but we have to unlock the vendor similar to the new mole. Okay, he wants to cleanse us of the light's impurity. I suppose so. As Runor lightly sprays you with water, your skin begins to tingle. A Lin Tutor. Okay, I guess we'll make some introductions. Elderly woman smiles warmly at our greeting. Hello there, Serenity. It has been a long time. I hope you're doing well. Okay. Seems to be fairly well greeted. Let's see how Minfilia's been getting on. And of course, we have a nice selection of side quests, one including an Aether Current. Let's go grab them before we continue the main storyline. We are level 80, so it's not really required. We're not going to get the experience benefit, but that's fine. Want to learn more about Slitherbough and the community here. What we do for family. Thorfinn is in a hurry, but not in such a hurry that he would deny a helping hand. So his companion, his friend, has disappeared. And we believe he's went back to Fort Gone. And we have a password, so he knows we are friend. Okay, we'll go in search of him. What else do we have here? We have Marill. Plan's gone awry. Marill looks as though he's expecting someone. Oh, we've been given the same password again. Maybe it's just a password of Slitherbough. Oh well, we'll keep that in mind. Barking up the right tree. We'll get some dyes. Harveen is dreading her next journey into the woods. We have 4 bits of peeling bark from a tree which is containing the fruit of the protector. I think we saw that when we arrived in this region. As well, we have the caring carpenter. Like pulling teeth. This caring carpenter could use a sharp eye and a steady hand. Okay, we're going to be making use of blow darts to deal with swine and take their tusks. And we might as well pick up the fifth quest while we're here. Tea time. Vondia has tea to brew, but no ingredients to do so. Okay. Keep an eye out for some tea mushrooms. They are found to the south. Given some preserving agent to use on the mushrooms. Okay. For the missing hunting party, which is apparently to the north here. Nope, that's good. Hunters chasing quarry has asked us to look for a new hunter to the community. Ah, I'm glad to hear it, Serenity. Yeah, I've been enjoying the story as it progresses myself. Oh. Just taking my time with it. Heading back. I wonder if once we get back to the village, maybe we can just switch classes and actually just turn in the quest for the experience. We could just do that. Cheating slightly, but yeah, doesn't matter in the end. Okay, we're going to use the blow dart. And stun a swine so we can gain their tusks. Ooh. We do have a really good view of the area. Enjoying the Dark Knight, actually. Still ever learning. Okay, pluck the tusk and then head back to the village. Yeah, I don't know how I'd feel about a Dark Knight, but I've been having some good fun. Okay, here is the Tree of the Protector. We need the bark from here. Yeah, I got my dancer up to level 79, but I felt like I wanted to play a class which had a bit more, you wouldn't have to kite so much, a bit more survivability, and just get into the thick of things. So I could have played the Gunbreaker, of course, but I want to try the Dark Knight. It makes sense for the theme of the Warrior of Darkness. Some just on the base here. Couple of bits of bark hiding. Ah, there's one. Guessing the other's gonna be over here somewhere. Oh, was there only three? Oh, three out of four. Where's the fourth bit then? Oh, it's all the way back there. I see. I thought I was going to jump off there. Okay. And now just to the south, we need to gather those mushrooms and look for the missing friend. There's a boss fight nearby. We'll see if anyone's actually bothering involving themselves with that. It doesn't look like there's any real fates ongoing in this region. Like, no one's really doing them for now. Probably do a boss fight ourselves, but solo it would take so long. Okay, Okay. You have mushrooms. The other two hiding. Oh, there's one behind here. Ah, and there's the other one. Oh. So he had to treat them all individually, now we need to gather them. Okay. A little bit awkward, but fair enough. Remind me of a quest in the South Shroud, where you need to gather some water from the river. And it's not just going to the river and picking up the water, you need to pick up the bucket, put the bucket in the water, use the bucket to pick up the water, pick up the water-laden bucket. It's just like, you could have done it in one or two actions rather than five. The boss fight. Somewhere. Obviously, his friend said Fort Gond, which is just in the distance there. But he is here. Cons is poisoned. Serum, which is just to the north. Yeah, Slitherbough serum, an all-purpose anti-venom. Venom. There you go. Yeah. Form the words. Thank you. Okay. Looks like it's the beginning of a quest chain. Doesn't give us any more Aether currents, of course, but seemingly Cons is here, is searching for something in regards to his father. Okay. Let's go in search of Khan's father's sword. Oh, there's another boss fight. Escort Farfan through the ruins. Should you fail to defend him or move too far away, he will return to the outskirts of Fort Gon. Okay. Lead the way. Yeah, I guess we're leading. Sword lying here. It is not the correct one, though. And here's another. With this one. Nope. How about... level 80 skill. Oh, awesome. Okay, back to his friend. Switch class to see if we can turn this in as another class, just to benefit from the experience. Switch over to a white mage. He has your father's abandoned blade. For us, pick their poison. Despite having his father's sword, you suspect Karns is not yet ready to return. So Karns wants to place poisoned meat around the abandoned fort. So that some of the aggressive wildlife will be killed off. This doesn't go horribly wrong. It is spoiled meat, so no one else but the wildlife should pick it up, but you never know. Meat planted. How are the others doing? And I guess back to the village they go. Awesome. Switch over to my white mage again. May as well. We'll just turn in our quest just to benefit from the experience. bit of the blue spirit armor set. Little Marill. This is about the hapless hunter who ran away. Tea mushrooms you asked for. Way. Indeed I have. Here's your tusk from the jagged swine. Here's the 4 bits of peeling bark. I suppose we'll just take the silver pieces. Let's go speak to, I guess, the village elder or chief once again. Helping hand. Judging from the glint in Runar's eye, there is more for you to learn about Slitherbough. We already have, but I suppose we are guests, we should try to be polite. What would you have us do? That's a pretty hefty jug. Okay, tend to the crops while they make preparations for our stay. Jug, why didn't you pick the next biggest jug that doesn't have a crack in it? You know, we could make two journeys. We watered half the plot. We need to do it again. Oh, the same, we only have 30 seconds. There we are. Nice and easy. more blue spirit armor. And that was the waste. Lost but not forgotten. Runar has even more work to be done. Okay, research for a heartstone, a pendant that's given to the villagers of Slitherbough at their birth, and it's east of Fort Gone. Seems promising. And of course, the item we seek is probably in the middle of that field. Should be able to handle two of them. God damn it. Philia didn't bite off more than she could chew. Oh! Good job. Quite a large region to search. Oh, hi. Sit under this pile of leaves. Seems so. Sake once belonging to Tardia of the Knights Blessed. And back to the village we go. Hopefully the Sun Eaters haven't attacked while we've been away. Vancred's not impressed. She did all right for herself. Saying goodbye. Runar lets out a sigh of relief. To watch the ceremony. Speak to the Placid Elder and learn about, well, learn if there's any customs we should be aware of. The music stopped when we ended here. Elderly woman hands you a candle. She then points over to a nearby corner where you might place it. I guess I'll go do that then. A blue flamed candle.
It seemed only right that we show our faces. May we join you?
Let us begin. I thank you all for coming to pay respects to our fallen daughter of the night. In the light, she was known as Todia, but in the dark, we shall remember her always as Menin. Let us each take a moment to offer her our prayers. We entrust her now to the night's sweet embrace. In darkness, will she be free from pain and suffering, now and forevermore. May her soul find peace in the sunless sea of heaven, and in the love we bear for her in our hearts.
That vessel represents the night sky, the sunless sea of heaven.
Call upon you now, O bringer of shadow, to lead this gentle soul unto the sea. We call upon you, O warrior of darkness, to deliver her unto paradise everlasting.
I am told you assisted in the preparations for the service. On behalf of the Blessed, you have my sincerest thanks. The enduring legend of the Warrior of Darkness owes much to the traditions of these people. And none were more ardent in their faith than Todia. She would have been greatly moved by your presence.
You might not deliver her to the heavens, but if you could deliver the night sky to her people, the real night sky, it would be the next best thing. Their prayers would finally be answered. They could gaze up at the firmament and see their ancestors in every twinkle of the stars. We We cannot allow their hopes and dreams to drown in the light. We have to bring back the dark. If we don't, who will? Forgive me, thinking of all those we have lost.
No, it's all right. We will bring back the dark.
Mayhap sooner than later, in fact. Eorzea and I have finished deciphering the tablet, and its contents were most illuminating. Let us reconvene in my chambers. We have much to discuss.
So, that ancient tablet. Well, ancient. Beyond 100-year-old tablet may have the information to gain us access to the eastern fringes of the Great Wood. Maybe it's a way to get past the highly territorial people. See what Eustola has to say. Yeah, I noticed how Fancred kind of reacted to how Minfilia was, how passionate she was to return the night sky to this region. Bunch of quests has made itself available to us here in Slitherbough. Tell you what, this is a good place to take a break. Should I help out the villagers of Slitherbough some more before learning what the tablet has to say? Decisions. Tell you what, I will take a break here. And before we start the next stream or the next video, I'll spend a bit of time myself. I'll do maybe 3 of those, I think 7. Maybe 8. I'll do 3 or 4 of those side quests in my own time just to see what and how we can help the villagers here. And then when we come back, we'll actually just continue and crack over the main storyline. I'll leave a few of the quests just for maybe another class in the future. Yeah, that's probably the best way to do it, in my own mind right now. So, thank you all for joining me, and as I say, I will hopefully see you in the next stream or the next video if you're watching this later on YouTube. And when we come back, we'll see what this tablet has in store for us, and how it might help us locate the Light Warden here in the Raktika Greatwood. As I say, thank you for joining me, and if I don't stream again this evening, hopefully I'll see you for even more streams in the future. But until then, take care. Bye-bye now.